Macmillan Audio presents The Gilded Auction Block, written and read by Shane McCrae. The President Visits the Storm. What a crowd, what a turnout. Donald Trump to victims of Hurricane Harvey. America, you're what a turnout. Great crowd, a great crowd. Big smiles, America. The hurricane is everywhere, but here an important man is talking here. America, the important president is talking. And if the heavens open up, the heavens open above the president. The heavens open to assume him bodily into heaven, as they have opened to assume great men who will come back and bring the end with them. America, he trumpets the end of your suffering, both swan and horseman trumpeting from the back of the beast. The fire and rose are one on the president's bright head. The flames implanted to make a gilded crown, America, the hurricane is everywhere but here. America, a great man is a poison that kills the sky, the weather in the sky, for who, America, can look above him? You're what a great, a crowd, big smiles, the ratings, the body of a storm is a man's body. It has an eye and everything in the eye is dead. A calm man is a man who has let weakness overcome his urge for death. America, the president is talking. You're what a great a turnout. You could be anywhere, but your anywhere is here. And every inch of the stadium, except those feet occupied by the stage, after his speech will be used to shelter those displaced by the storm. Except those feet occupied by their armed folks. Police assigned to guard the stage, which must remain in place for the duration of the hurricane, except those feet of dead, unmarked space called the safety zone between those officers and you. You must not violate the safety zone. You must not leave the safety zone. The president suggests you find the edge. It's at a common sense distance. It is farther than you can throw a rock. No farther than a bullet flies. Section 1. I fight him, Ann Parker. I fell and broke my arm some time ago, 'cause my right side am dead. And me, I tries to crawl off in the bed. I is 103 years old. When I gets back from the hospital, they ties me in this chair. I was a grown woman at the end of the war. The boy who helps me up and down, he wasn't raised like me, he don't got the same manners, but we old ones know we still has got to be polite to you white ladies. Daughter, did I tell you? My mammy Jenny was a queen in Africa, and I ain't had no daddy, 'cause queens don't marry. Yes, she was a queen. And when she told them at the farm, they bowed. She told them not to tell it, tell the master, and they didn't tell. But when the white folks wasn't looking, she was a queen. The boy who ties and unties the rope, he says it don't matter who my mammy was, now that we's free. He fusses and I fight him, and he says a queen don't act that way. Daughter, you make sure you tell him, 'cause he don't know, and you don't know, a queen won't die a slave. Everything I know about blackness I learned from Donald Trump. Frederick Douglass is an example of somebody who's done an amazing job and is being recognized more and more, I notice. Donald Trump. America, I was driving when I heard you had died. I swerved into a ditch and wept in the dream I dreamed, unconscious in the ditch. America, I dreamed you climbed from the ditch, you must believe your body is, and any body, and stood beside the ditch for 8 years, thinking. Except you didn't stand, you right away lay down on your pale belly and tried to claw your way back to the ditch. You right away began to wail and weep and gnash your teeth. My tears met yours in the ditch, America. They carry me downstream, a slave on the run from you, an Egyptian queen, and even in my dreams, I'm in your dreams. Black Joe Arpaio. America, you wouldn't pardon me, even if I was truly, I was sorry. Even if I had worked so hard and truly to keep the Mexicans on the other side of the river. Even if I had myself built turrets on a wall I built myself, complete with searchlights and machine guns, white men chewing toothpicks as they scanned the brown horizon. Either through binoculars or aviator sunglasses, the only sign of the expressions on their faces would be their teeth. You wouldn't pardon me, even if I had locked every freeway down, and every highway, every street and road, and back road, every drive down, with police checkpoints, even if I had made sure each cop...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.